nightmare woke him up. Frightened by his mother's bedtime story, he searched for his sister's comfort. But she was nowhere to be found. There once was a girl who snuck out of her bedroom window at night, even though her mother had told her not to. She went into the forest, and at first it welcomed her with warmth and a promise of adventures. But soon the forest seemed to grow colder and darker. The girl was afraid, and she wanted to go home. But Bramble crawled around her arms and legs, and she could not get away. And the girl was never seen again. That is what happens when you do not listen to your mother. Especially you, Lilimor, their mother had said before kissing them goodnight. The darkness outside scared him. But not being with his sister scared him even more. The nearby forest was a familiar place during the day, night, it was a different story. There was no trace of Lillemor, and Ulle wished he could ask the pine cones if they had seen her. But if the pine cones knew about her fate, they kept it to themselves. A light in the dark. A symbol of hope. A spark of courage. What do you have there? Lilimur asked. It glimmers beautifully. What a strange rock. Light as a feather. She investigated closely. Let us play, little brother, Lilimur bubbled. See if you can knock down this pine cone. Together, they tumbled down deeper and deeper through the old ruin. Follow me, little brother. I will protect you, Lilimur said. She was never scared like him. Ulle wished he could be a little more like his sister. Lilimur loved adventures, and Ulle loved Lilimur. Gnomes are peculiar and playful creatures. They live peacefully in daylight and keep in their houses at night. Visitors that don't want to eat them were unheard of until this day.
Huh?
They were both curious in different ways, while Lillemor quickly ran along. Ulle could get completely enthralled. And suddenly, Ulle was alone again. The river was strong, and Ulle was weak. He did not stand a chance. But soon the sound of the river faded. Ulle was happy to have firm ground under his feet again. Thank you. Frog King made sure that his new friend did not drown. But without his sister, he felt like the loneliest child in the world. He just wanted to find Lilimor and go home. To do that, he had to find where the big troll had taken her.
Thank you.
Ole wanted to cry. A couple of hours ago, he had been in his warm bed. Now, he had almost died several times. His sister was gone, and he was soaked in smelly sewer water.